In this video, we are going to learn about a cool concept, building hybrid apps. Imagine combining the best parts of native apps, like the ones on your phone, and web apps, like the ones you use in your browser. Well, that's what we are going to do. Let's jump right in and discover how we can make this magic happen. I have created a fresh empty solution in Visual Studio named MAUI Hybrid Demo. Now let's proceed to create a new .NET MAUI Blazor app project. Within the Project Types dropdown, you can choose MAUI to access project types associated with MAUI. In the provided list, you will find the option labeled .NET MAUI Blazor app. Alternatively, you can locate the same option by filtering for Blazor project types. As you can see here, the identical option is available. Let's proceed with the project creation process using the specified project name, MAUI Blazor app. I'm creating it. Before we move ahead, I want to let you know that we have a special tutorial series all about .NET MAUI. If you're looking to dive deeper into this exciting technology, you can find the entire playlist link in the video description below. Within the Solution Explorer, you will notice a familiar arrangement of files and folders resembling those typically found in both MAUI and Blazor projects. This combination includes parts of both types of projects. Inside the Platforms folder, you'll find the folders specific to various platforms such as Android, iOS, Mac Catalyst, Tizen, and Windows. Additionally, there is a Resources folder similar to what you would find in a MAUI app. Within this structure, you will come across Pages and Shared folders, mirroring the arrangement you see in a Blazor project. I'll now open the IndexRaiser component. The content closely resembles what you would find in a Blazor project. You can create the design of these Raiser components using HTML elements, just as we do in a normal Blazor project. Inside the CounterRaiser component, we can see a button that when clicked will increase the value of the current count variable. Moving on to the fish data raiser component, you will notice a table element designed to exhibit mock weather information. Now let's navigate to the mauiprogram.cs class. Inside this class, you will observe the incorporation of a MAUI WebView service into the dependency service. Additionally, there is a designated section that will only run when the app is being debugged. Within this section, a Blazor WebView Developer Tools service is integrated. This facilitates the ability to press the F12 key and access developer options while debugging the application. I'll demonstrate this functionality to you. Let's proceed by opening the mainpage.xaml file. In this file, you will come across a Blazor WebView element. The Blazor WebView serves as a component that allows you to incorporate a Blazor web application within your .NET MAUI application. In this specific instance, you will notice that the host page property has been set to www.root/index.html. Consequently, this page is essentially loaded within the Blazor WebView control, establishing the connection between the two. Now let's explore the contents of the www.root folder. In this folder, you will find a CSS directory where the CSS files are stored, similar to the structure of a standard Blazor app. Now let's open the index.html file. Inside, you will notice the inclusion of essential CSS and JavaScript files that are imported for the project's functionality. Firstly, let's attempt to run the application on Android and observe how the pages are presented within our MAUI app. You'll notice that the Blazor WebView control is directed to the root page. Now let's proceed to the counter page. Here, the Click Me button is effectively increasing the counter value. On the Fetch Data page, you will find the simulated weather information being displayed. Now I'll demonstrate how you can access the developer options. Let's execute the application on a Windows machine. As you can observe, the MAUI app functions smoothly here as well. From any of the app's pages, simply press F12 key and the developer options window will appear. You can utilize this window just as you would in a typical web application. If our goal is to create a hybrid application that can be deployed as both a mobile or desktop app and a web application, it's essential to share the code base among these platforms. Let's explore how this can be achieved. To begin, we'll initiate the creation of a Blazor web project. In this example, I'm opting for the Blazor server app template from the available project templates. However, you have the flexibility to choose the Blazor WebAssembly app if you prefer. Let's proceed by providing the project name as Blazor server app and then creating the project. Before we proceed further, I would like to highlight that we also offer an informative tutorial series on Blazor. If you are eager to learn more about this technology, you can access the complete playlist through the link provided in the video description. At this point, the Solution Explorer displays two distinct projects, a .NET MAUI Blazor app and the newly added Blazor server app. The next step involves sharing the Razor components between these two projects. To achieve this, I am adding another project to our solution. We'll change the project type to All Project Types. From there, we'll search for Razor Class Library, which you can find listed at the top. I'll proceed by creating a project using this option. An automatically generated Razor component named Component1 is present, but it's not necessary. You can delete it if desired. Let's proceed to create a new Razor component. I'm assigning it the name Customer Component. In the code section, I'll create a model class called Customer with two properties, name and email. In this component, we'll implement the functionality to add customers to a table. To achieve this functionality in the customer component, we'll need a list of customers to display in the table, a customer object named model that we'll use when adding a new customer, a method called addCustomer to incorporate the process of adding a new customer to the list. We'll begin by placing an input element where users can enter the customer's name. To establish the connection, we'll bind the value of this input to the name property of the model object. Subsequently, I'll add another input element, this time for entering the customer's email address. Similar to before, we'll set up the necessary binding for this input. For the process of adding a customer, we'll incorporate a button. Within the onClick event of this button, we'll invoke the addCustomer method. Lastly, we'll include a table in the design. This table will be used to display the list of added customers. In the layout structure, you'll notice that if there are any customers present in the list, I'm utilizing a foreach loop to generate distinct rows within the table. On the other hand, if the list is empty, the table will display the message "No customers added." Let's proceed to implement this Razor component in both projects. We'll begin by integrating it into the index page of the Blazor server app project. To utilize the Razor component, we first need to reference the project. Once this is done, typing the component name will display it in the suggestions. I'm simplifying the usage by removing the namespace from the component tag, as we can directly import it. Let's proceed to run the Blazor server app project and observe its functionality. You'll notice that the elements we integrated within the Razor component are now visible on the index page. Upon attempting to add a customer record, you'll find that the addition is successful and the customer data we entered is correctly presented in the table, aligning with our expectations. Let's proceed to incorporate the same component into our .NET MAUI Blazor app. To achieve this, I'll add the necessary project reference. Subsequently, we can place the component within the index page of .NET MAUI Blazor app. Now, we'll run the application in the Android emulator to determine whether it operates smoothly. The application loads successfully and you can observe the consistent design. Moving forward, I would like to highlight a significant aspect. Consider the scenario where there is a requirement to incorporate platform-specific methods within the MAUI framework. For instance, consider the requirement to display an alert message using the DisplayAlert method available within the MAUI platform. However, this approach might not be suitable for browser environments. In such cases, an alternative method such as utilizing a JavaScript alert may be necessary in Blazor server app. Let's proceed to explore the implementation of these functionalities. Within our customer Razor component, I am introducing an additional button. When this button is clicked, an alert message should be displayed. To accomplish this, I am utilizing the Blazor parameter attribute. Subsequently, I am creating a public event callback named showAlert. For the newly added button's click event, I am associating it with this event callback, which can then be passed as a parameter. Firstly, let's pass this parameter from our MAUI Blazor project. In the code section, I am introducing a new method. The method name is showAlert, although you can choose a different name if preferred. Within this method, I am utilizing application.current.mainpage.displayAlert. Parameters like title, message, and cancel text can be provided to this method. Finally, we can assign this method to the component's parameter named showAlert. Now let's move to the Blazor server app. Within this project, we need to display the alert using a JavaScript function. Similarly, I am introducing a new method in this context. To interact with JavaScript methods, I am injecting the IJS runtime service. We can then directly invoke the JavaScript alert method and provide the message. Subsequently, we'll assign this method to the event callback parameter for seamless functionality. Let's proceed to run both projects concurrently. Within the solution properties, I'm selecting multiple start projects and adjusting the action settings for both projects. Now I'll initiate the execution. This will open both the Android emulator and the browser simultaneously. Let's begin by testing it on Android. As you can observe, the Android native alert dialog is displayed. On the other hand, in the Blazor server app project, the conventional browser-based alert is being presented. In the MAUI Blazor app, let's add another feature to examine internet connectivity. This functionality is commonly required in mobile or desktop apps. I'll implement this by checking the connectivity within an if condition. If no connectivity is detected, I'm displaying an additional alert. It's noteworthy that connectivity class is located under microsoft.maui.networking. Just like in a standard MAUI app, these methods can be utilized within a MAUI Blazor app as well. Let's proceed to run the project in the Android emulator and conduct a test. Initially, I'll enable airplane mode to simulate a lack of internet connectivity. As expected, the app displays the connectivity alert upon clicking the button. Subsequently, I'll disable the airplane mode and click the button again. At this point, you'll notice that the connectivity alert doesn't appear, as connectivity has been restored. We hope you have enjoyed this tutorial and gained valuable insights into the art of building versatile apps. Thank you for joining us today, and we look forward to seeing you in our next video. Happy coding!